She felt sorry for the families and wanted them to be able to put their daughters' bodies to rest. Gonzalez said that his brother was one of the six people involved in killing the girls and gave the police names of all but one, which was the new recruit, because he did not know his name. His knowledge of the crimes came from the killers themselves, most of whom came to his home after the murders, bragging and swapping the jewelry that they had stolen from Jennifer and Elizabeth. While Jenny and Elizabeth were living the last few hours of their lives, Peter Cantu, Efrain Perez, Derek Sean O'Brien, Joe Medellin, and Joe's 14-year-old brother were initiating a new member, Raul Villarreal, into their gang known as the Black and Whites. Raul was an acquaintance of Efrain and was not known to the other gang members. They had spent the evening drinking beer and then jumping in Raul. The gang continued drinking and shooting the breeze for some time and then decided to leave. Two brothers who had been with them but were not in the gang left first and passed Jenny and Elizabeth, who were unknowingly walking towards their deaths. When Peter Cantu saw the girls, he thought it was a man and a woman from far away. And he told the gang that he wanted to jump them. So the gang members ran and grabbed Elizabeth and pulled her down the incline off the tracks. Testimony showed that Jenny had gotten free, but turned back when she heard Elizabeth screaming for her. So for the next hour or so, these beautiful, innocent young girls were subjected to the most brutal gang rapes. One of the members bragged about having virgin blood on him. Now this is where it's gonna start getting graphic, if you can't tell. The 14-year-old juvenile later testified that he had gone back and forth between his brother and Peter Cantu and kept urging them to leave. He said he was repeatedly told by Peter Cantu to get some. So he raped Jennifer and was later sentenced to 40 years for aggravated sexual assault, which was the max sentence for a juvenile. So when the rapes finally ended, the horror was not over. The gang members took Jennifer and Elizabeth from the clearing and into a wooded area, leaving the juvenile behind, saying that he was too little to watch. So Jennifer was strangled with the belt of Sean O'Brien, with two of the gang members pulling on each side of the belt until the belt broke. So part of the belt was left at the crime scene, and the rest of it they ended up finding in O'Brien's home later. So after the belt broke, the killers used her own shoelaces to finish their job. Madeline later complained that the bitch wouldn't die, and that it would have been easier with a gun. Elizabeth was also strangled with her shoelaces. The medical examiner testified that Elizabeth's two front teeth were knocked out before she died, and that two of Jennifer's ribs were broken after she died. Testimony showed that the girls' bodies were kicked and stomped on after the strangulations to make sure that they were really dead. The juvenile pled guilty and was sentenced to 40 years in prison, and the other five members were tried for capital murder in Harris County, Texas, and they were all five sentenced to death. 6 months before Jennifer and Elizabeth were murdered,
Appreciate it.